Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Enigmatic Perfumery in Paris. Chapter 1. The Vintage Elixir. In the heart of Paris, a city draped in a tapestry of timeless allure, Sophie found herself wandering through the narrow streets of Le Marais. The scent of history hung in the air, blending seamlessly with the fragrant notes of freshly baked croissants and blooming flowers from the nearby boulangeries. As an avid enthusiast of all things olfactory, Sophie often sought solace in the city's lesser-known corners, where the secrets of Paris whispered through the wind. On this particular day, an old-fashioned sign caught her eye, a faded emblem reading, "La Parfumerie Enigmatique." The quaint perfumery beckoned, its windows adorned with antique bottles and aged labels that hinted at a bygone era of glamour and sophistication. Intrigued, Sophie pushed open the creaking door, and a delicate chime announced her arrival. The perfumery, a dimly lit haven filled with the subtle hum of classical melodies, held an enchanting ambience. Wooden shelves adorned with dust-laden bottles and glass cases housing vintage flakons showcased the rich history contained within these walls. As Sophie meandered through the narrow aisles, she felt a magnetic pull towards a forgotten corner. There, amidst a collection of long-neglected relics, she discovered it. An exquisite vintage perfume bottle, adorned with intricate filigree and bearing the marks of time. The liquid within, an amber elixir, seemed to hold within it the essence of a Paris long past. Sophie's heart quickened with excitement as she carefully cradled the bottle in her hands. With the delicate precision of a seasoned perfumer, she uncorked the bottle, releasing a waft of fragrance that transported her to an era when Parisian elegance was synonymous with enchantment. The scent, though aged, retained a complexity that hinted at layers of history waiting to be unraveled. It was a symphony of floral and spicy notes, with undertones of mysterious woods and subtle whispers of musk. Sophie was aware that this old-fashioned elixir had the secret to a hidden tale that was interwoven into the fragrance itself. Determined to discover its mysteries, she made the decision to follow the scent that once enthralled the affluent as she set out on a tour through Paris's winding alleyways. Her first destination was the historic district of Saint-Germain-des-Prés, where literary giants and artists once congregated in smoky cafes. Sophie believed that the vintage elixir might have its origins in the intellectual circles that defined this quarter. As she strolled along the Seine, she envisioned a lost love story unfolding in dimly lit bookshops and clandestine gatherings. The second stop on her quest took her to the exquisite gardens of Versailles. If the fragrance held the echoes of a romance, surely the opulent palace and its majestic surroundings would reveal more. As Sophie wandered through the meticulously manicured lawns and fragrant flowerbeds, she couldn't shake the feeling that each petal held a secret. Each breeze whispered a tale. Venturing further, she explored the tucked away ateliers in Montmartre, where visionary artists once sought inspiration. The vintage elixir might have been crafted amidst the vibrant strokes of painters and the musings of poets. In the heart of the Bohemian district, Sophie discovered a hidden workshop adorned with forgotten vials and aged parchment. Clues to the perfume's composition lay hidden among the remnants of artistic fervor. The Parfumerie Enigmatique, where Sophie's journey began, became a nexus of discovery. Within its walls, she stumbled upon ancient manuscripts and forgotten recipes, each hinting at the ingredients that composed the elusive fragrance. The perfumery's archives, filled with the wisdom of generations past, became a treasure trove of knowledge waiting to be unlocked. As Sophie delved deeper into her exploration, the vintage elixir became not only a key to the perfume's composition, but also a portal to a world of intrigue and mystery. The perfumery's aging proprietor, Madame Amélie, recognized Sophie's fervor and shared tales of Parisian allure from decades past. Her anecdotes painted vivid pictures of romantic rendezvous, whispered confessions, and the timeless elegance that defined the fragrance. The vintage elixir, now a vessel of history, guided Sophie through hidden libraries, forgotten chapels, and secluded courtyards. In each location, she uncovered fragments of the lost love story, a stolen glance beneath the arches of the Louvre, a lingering touch along the Seine's embankment, and a promise whispered amidst the flickering candles of Notre Dame. As Sophie pieced together the first chapter of her aromatic odyssey, the vintage elixir became not just a perfume, but a catalyst for a journey through the labyrinth of love and intrigue. The streets of Paris, with their secrets and mysteries, awaited further exploration. As Sophie continued to decipher the components of the fragrance that had enraptured the elite of a bygone era. The vintage elixir, now interwoven with Sophie's destiny, propelled her deeper into the heart of the enigmatic tale that unfolded with each fragrant step through the City of Lights. Chapter 2. The Perfumed Trail. Emboldened by the enchantment of the vintage elixir, Sophie's journey through the perfumed tapestry of Paris gained momentum. Armed with the newfound knowledge from the Parfumerie Enigmatique's archives, she set out to decode the intricate components of the vintage perfume, guided by the fragrant whispers of the past. Her quest led her to a forgotten library tucked away in the Latin Quarter, an enclave of scholarly pursuits and quiet contemplation. Dusty manuscripts on the art of perfumery adorned the weathered shelves, and the hushed tones of diligent researchers created a cocoon of scholarly reverence. Sophie, with a determined glint in her eyes, pored over ancient texts that promised to unveil the alchemy of scents. Among the leather-bound volumes, Sophie unearthed a treatise written by a long-forgotten perfumer who had once graced the cobblestone streets of Montmartre. The yellowed pages contained cryptic notes, revealing rare botanicals and elusive essences that hinted at the vintage perfume's intricate composition. The perfumer's annotations, reminiscent of a bygone era, spoke of moonlit concoctions and clandestine gatherings where fragrances became poetry. Armed with this newfound wisdom, Sophie ventured into the heart of Montmartre, where the artistic spirit of Paris pulsed through every brushstroke and melody. The ateliers, hidden along the winding streets, held the promise of revelations. Sophie imagined the perfumer, inspired by the colors and sounds of bohemian life, crafting a fragrance that transcended the mundane. One atelier, adorned with faded canvases and antique vials, stood frozen in time. Sophie sensed the lingering presence of artistic fervor as she carefully inspected the forgotten formulae strewn across a worn wooden table. The perfumer's creative process unfolded before her. The careful selection of rare blooms from the gardens of Montmartre, the alchemical blending of essences, and the passionate strokes of a perfumer's brush on an aromatic canvas. The vintage elixir's trail then led Sophie to the enchanting gardens of Montmartre, where rare blooms once danced in the breeze, inspiring the creation of the elusive fragrance. Amidst the vibrant colors and fragrant blossoms, Sophie discovered a hidden greenhouse where exotic flowers, mentioned in the ancient treatise, still bloomed. The perfumer's choice of petals seemed to mirror the romantic dance of love that had permeated the air. Wandering through the cobbled streets, Sophie envisioned the perfumer's footsteps echoing through the lively squares and quiet alleyways. A discreet boutique nestled between art galleries and quaint bistros caught her attention. It bore the faded sign of l'atelier de secret, the workshop of secrets. Intrigued, she entered, and a bell chimed softly. Inside, shelves lined with dusty flakons and antique bottles held the essence of forgotten tales. A wizened proprietor, the keeper of long-lost fragrances, greeted her with a knowing smile. Madame Lucienne, the guardian of these olfactory treasures, sensed Sophie's quest and shared anecdotes of love and longing that permeated the air of Montmartre during the era when the vintage perfume was born. Madame Lucienne revealed that the elusive fragrance had been a well-guarded secret among the bohemian circles, a muse for poets and a talisman for artists. Sophie listened with rapt attention as the tales unfurled. A clandestine soiree where the fragrance was unveiled, a midnight tryst in a hidden garden, and a whispered promise beneath the stars. With each revelation, Sophie's understanding of the vintage perfume deepened. The fragrant trail led her to hidden chapels, where clandestine lovers sought solace in the sacred silence. The aged stones seemed to retain the echoes of vows exchanged and secrets shared, intertwining the fragrance with the emotions of a time when love blossomed amidst the shadows. But the perfumed trail had more to offer. Sophie, now attuned to the cadence of the vintage elixir, followed the fragrant whispers to the banks of the Seine. Beneath the arches of iconic bridges, she imagined stolen glances and furtive touches, a river of emotions flowing through the heart of Paris. The culmination of her journey through Montmartre brought Sophie to a hidden catacomb beneath the bustling streets. The subterranean chambers, adorned with the remnants of forgotten affairs and entangled destinies, held the final pieces of the puzzle. The perfume's essence, crafted in the clandestine corners of Montmartre, resonated with the spirits of lovers who had sought refuge in the timeless embrace of the city. As Sophie emerged from Montmartre, her heart resonated with the fragrant symphony that echoed through the hidden ateliers, enchanted gardens, and secret chambers. The perfumed trail, though revealing glimpses of a lost love story, beckoned her further into the labyrinth of Paris, where each location held the promise of unraveling another layer of the enigmatic fragrance's tale. The vintage elixir, now interwoven with the artistic spirit of Montmartre, propelled Sophie towards the next chapter of her aromatic odyssey. Chapter 3, Whispers of the Past. As Sophie continued her aromatic odyssey through the labyrinth of Paris, she felt an intoxicating allure emanating from the vintage elixir. The perfumed trail, now woven into the very fabric of her senses, led her to the historic Louvre, an opulent palace that stood as a witness to centuries of art, culture, and clandestine affairs. The grandeur of the Louvre unfolded before Sophie, its majestic halls echoing with the footsteps of those who had once sought refuge in its opulence. As she entered the Louvre's hallowed halls, adorned with priceless works of art, Sophie imagined the perfumer's clandestine rendezvous in these very rooms. The vintage elixir, intricately connected to the cultural tapestry of Paris, whispered secrets that lingered amidst the masterpieces. The fragrance guided Sophie to a secluded gallery where moonlit soirees had once played host to artistic musings and whispered confessions. The aged marble seemed to retain the echoes of stolen glances and the intoxicating dance of emotions that unfolded beneath the gaze of timeless portraits. As Sophie traced her fingers along the cold stone walls, she felt the vibrations of an untold love story resonating through the centuries. Her exploration led her to an intimate chamber, secluded from the prying eyes of the world. The air in the room held a lingering fragrance, a delicate blend of the vintage elixir and the passion that had once thrived in the shadows. Sophie envisioned clandestine meetings between a talented perfumer and a captivating muse, their shared moments etched in the very essence of the perfume. With each step, Sophie uncovered cryptic clues, subtle markings on the walls, concealed compartments within antique furnishings, and whispered tales from the lips of the Louvre's caretakers. The vintage elixir, now intertwined with the historical secrets of the Louvre, revealed a narrative that transcended time. As she ventured deeper into the heart of Paris, Sophie felt an irresistible pull towards the moonlit banks of the Seine. Beneath the arches of iconic bridges, she imagined the perfumer and muse exchanging promises in the soft glow of night. The vintage elixir, a silent witness to these clandestine trysts, seemed to mirror the luminous reflections on the tranquil waters. Her journey then took her to the revered Notre Dame Cathedral, an architectural masterpiece that stood as a silent guardian of Parisian tales. Within its sacred confines, Sophie discovered hidden alcoves and secluded chapels that bore witness to forbidden love. The vintage elixir's fragrance, entwined with the echoes of whispered confessions and stolen kisses, added another layer to the enigmatic narrative. Madame Amélie, the wise proprietor of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, shared tales of Notre Dame's secret chambers, where the perfume's essence had once been guarded by vigilant souls. Sophie, with newfound determination, delved into the cathedral's mystical depths, guided by the fragrant whispers that resonated with divine and earthly passions alike. Among the time-worn stones and the soft glow of candlelight, Sophie uncovered the final pieces of the vintage elixir's puzzle. Fragments of a love story unfolded, a perfumer's devotion to capturing the essence of a muse, clandestine meetings in the cathedral's shadowed corners, and the poignant resonance of love that transcended societal norms. The perfumed trail then led Sophie to the Chamber of Echoing Whispers, an ethereal space where the fragrance of the vintage elixir seemed to come alive. The echoes of the past reverberated through the celestial air, revealing the perfumer's secrets, the muse's untold yearnings, and the timeless dance of emotions that had once unfolded beneath the cathedral's celestial arches. As Sophie emerged from Notre Dame, her senses ablaze with the fragrant revelations, she realized that the vintage elixir had become not just a perfume, but a vessel for memories and untold tales. The whispers of the past, entwined with the fragrance, painted an evocative portrait of a love story that defied the constraints of time. Her exploration through the historic landmarks of Paris had uncovered the multifaceted layers of the perfume's narrative, a tale woven into the very fabric of the city's cultural and romantic legacy. The vintage elixir, now enriched by the echoes of the Louvre and Notre Dame, beckoned Sophie towards the final chapters of her aromatic adventure. With each fragrant step, the connection between the vintage elixir and the captivating love story grew stronger, propelling Sophie deeper into the heart of Paris, a city where history, romance, and mystery converged in a dance of scents and secrets. The vintage elixir, now a vessel of whispered confessions and hidden passions, held the promise of an enigmatic culmination that awaited discovery in the streets of the City of Lights. Chapter 4, The Enigmatic Culmination. Emboldened by the fragrant revelations of her journey through Paris, Sophie stood on the threshold of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, a haven that had become a nexus of secrets and scents. The vintage elixir, now interwoven with the tales of the Louvre, Notre Dame, and the hidden corners of Montmartre, beckoned her towards the final act of her aromatic odyssey. Madame Amélie, the guardian of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, greeted Sophie with a knowing smile. The aged proprietor, a repository of the city's olfactory history, sensed the culmination of the perfumed trail in the air. As Sophie shared her journey, Madame Amélie nodded with a twinkle in her eyes, acknowledging the fragrant tapestry that had unfolded. Together, they descended into the subterranean chambers of the perfumery, an ancient space that had witnessed the crafting of countless elixirs and the preservation of aromatic legacies. The vintage elixir, now a symphony of scents that echoed through the hidden catacombs, seemed to guide Sophie towards a celestial culmination. The chamber, bathed in the soft glow of antique lamps, held an air of anticipation. Shelves lined with ancient manuscripts, vials of rare essences, and artifacts of perfumery spoke of the Parfumerie Enigmatique's illustrious past. Madame Amélie gestured towards a celestial pedestal where the original formula of the vintage elixir lay, carefully preserved for generations. As Sophie approached the celestial pedestal, the vintage elixir pulsated with a fragrant energy that resonated with the stories of love and intrigue she had uncovered. The celestial essence within it seemed to beckon towards a cosmic convergence, a merging of past and present, mortal and divine. Madame Amélie, with a gesture of reverence, urged Sophie to unlock the final secrets within the vintage elixir. The room seemed to hold its breath as Sophie, now a custodian of the fragrance's narrative, carefully examined the cryptic markings on the ancient formula. The celestial essence within the vintage elixir responded to Sophie's touch. Fragrance notes, reminiscent of moonlit rendezvous, secret gardens, and whispered confessions, danced in harmony. Each drop that blended into the cosmic mixture seemed to release an ethereal glow, illuminating the chamber with celestial luminescence. The fragrance's composition, a culmination of botanical symphonies and aromatic alchemy, mirrored the cultural tapestry of Paris. Floral notes from the gardens of Versailles, spicy undertones from hidden ateliers in Montmartre, and the sacred whispers of Notre Dame converged in a celestial ballet of scents. As Sophie neared the completion of the aromatic masterpiece, the vintage elixir became a living entity, a vessel for the emotions and stories woven into its essence. The celestial resonance within it seemed to echo through the very foundations of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, as if the fragrance had become a celestial guide through the city's enigmatic past. With the final drop added to the celestial blend, a transformative energy filled the chamber. The vintage elixir, now an embodiment of Parisian history and romance, pulsed with a fragrant radiance that transcended the boundaries of time. Madame Amélie, her eyes gleaming with satisfaction, nodded in acknowledgement of Sophie's accomplishment. The celestial culmination reached its zenith as the vintage elixir, now an olfactory masterpiece, seemed to transcend the earthly realm. A fragrant mist enveloped the chamber, carrying with it the essence of love, passion, and the timeless allure of Paris. The celestial resonance echoed through the perfumery, as if the very spirits of the city had gathered to witness the culmination of an enigmatic tale. As Sophie held the vintage elixir in her hands, she felt a profound connection to the city of lights and the stories that had unfolded within its cobblestone streets. The fragrance, now a celestial guide, beckoned towards a celestial legacy that would echo through the annals of Parisian perfumery. Madame Amélie, her role as guardian fulfilled, bestowed upon Sophie a celestial token, an antique locket containing a drop of the vintage elixir. The fragrance, now encapsulated in a tangible form, would serve as a reminder of Sophie's journey, a testament to the magic that lies within the perfumed enclaves of Paris. As Sophie emerged from the subterranean chambers of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, she carried with her not just a perfume, but a celestial legacy, a fragrance that bridged the gap between past and present, mortal and divine. The streets of Paris, now illuminated by the glow of the vintage elixir, seemed to whisper tales of an aromatic odyssey that had unfolded in the city's hidden corners. The Parfumerie Enigmatique, once a quiet witness to history, now bore the celestial resonance of Sophie's quest. Perfume enthusiasts and historians alike flocked to experience the resurrected fragrance, and the vintage elixir took its rightful place among the iconic scents of Paris. The enigmatic culmination, a celestial convergence of scents and stories, marked the end of Sophie's aromatic odyssey, an adventure that had unraveled the mysteries of an ancient perfumery and the secrets of a bygone era. As Sophie stood amidst the fragrant ambience of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, she felt a sense of fulfillment. The vintage elixir, now a celestial guide to the city's enigmatic past, had become a living testament to the magic that lies within the perfumed realms of Paris. The tale of the Parfumerie Enigmatique, intertwined with love, intrigue, and the celestial resonance of fragrances became a chapter in the olfactory history of the city, a legacy that would echo through the perfumed corridors of time.